Are you a believer? Let's actually talk Minnesota Timberwolves. You know, obviously, the Timberwolves this year are doing very, very well. They're on a tear. They won 31 games all last year. They're currently at 30 games right now, so they're most likely going to pass it up before All-Star break. You know, I said earlier on in the season that Jimmy Butler had to be the guy for this team in order for this team to be successful and for them to win. I was told that I was wrong, that it had to be Andrew Wiggins. And yes, of course, as always, I am correct.
Can't argue with that.
And basically, Tibbs has been, you know, doing a good job of managing this team. The big concern about, you know, the Minnesota Timberwolves is their defense. You know, currently they pretty much sit all the way, you know, kind of in that bottom half in terms of defense. They are currently ranked 21st. So that's the biggest, you know, question mark for them, which is ironic because you don't expect Tibbs teams to be, you know, defensively inefficient. Right. But, you know, Jimmy Butler has been playing good. Obviously, I think he deserves to be an All-Star. I named him on my All-Star roster last week on the last podcast. What do you guys think about Timberwolves?
I mean, over the last 10 games, the Timberwolves have the, as much as we talk about Tibbs and offense and we talk about the Timberwolves offense, they have the, as far as offensive rating goes, they're second in the league over the last 10 games. Second. And as far as defensive rating.
Where are you
rating,
seeing these stats at?
NBA.com.
Okay.
And,
No, because I'd be using, I use ESPN basketball reference,
and
so that's why.
As far as defensive rating, they are 11th over the last 10 games.
Okay.
So, I mean, yes. I believe in this Timberwolves team. Cat's been playing much better recently. Cat has actually been playing like he should be an All-Star. I think Cat will end up being an All-Star. Jimmy's been incredible. Jimmy's, to me, at first I thought Jimmy, like 4 years ago, I thought Jimmy was just like a system player. I thought he was. But Jimmy has improved exponentially. As far as like scoring, I don't know besides Harden and DeRozan, there's a better scorer at the two guard position. Uh-huh. Besides Jimmy. Like, Jimmy can pretty much get a bucket at will, however he wants to, whenever he wants to, for the most part right now. I like this team. I think there's a limit to how far they can go in the playoffs. I don't think this year is the year for them. Mm-hmm. To your point, I like Tyus Jones. I really like Tyus Jones.
Yeah, I really do. I personally am not a Jeff Teague fan.
I feel you. He got lambasted by Kyle Lowry last night. They gave that man 40 yeah, points. Lambasted by Lowry. You should not allow Kyle Lowry to get 40 points in 2018. Like, no. But yeah, I think the semifinals is like the limit for this team, but I think the future is bright in Minnesota.
I think the Western Conference Finals is the potential for this team.
This year?
I think
Karl-Anthony Towns in a series can, okay, look, I'll put it this way, right? When I'm thinking about these players and stuff, right? I'm thinking about in terms of talking about them in clutch situations, speaking of the Timberwolves and like them in the playoffs, right? I'm thinking about, can this player hit a god mode level to where he is so unstoppable that whether he's a number one or the number two or the number three option, that he can win you a playoff series when it matters? And I'm not necessarily talking about first, second round, or even getting you up to the second round, get past the second round, right, et cetera. Which is why I've never necessarily liked Chris Paul, because Chris Paul, yes, he can turn it on, but he's not going to go god mode to where he can win you those key games that matter.
He's
right?
Not, yeah.
He's too small.
PG is the same way. PG will get you to the conference finals. But he's not going to, in those big games as a number one or number two option, go god mode. And that's what you need.
He's putting Klay Thompson over Chris Paul.
Yes, I am. Yes, no. I am. And no. I'm not saying better player. I'm not saying better player. I'm not saying better player. I'm saying if you're talking about a guy that can win you playoff games. Playoff games and propel you forward. I'm not taking PG in that category. I'm not taking Chris Paul. I think Karl-Anthony Towns has that potential in him.
I think, but
I disagree with that. Because my biggest problem with Karl-Anthony Towns is that I don't necessarily, although he's like a dog and a fucking superstar, I think in the making, he doesn't necessarily have that moment to where in big games, I feel like he is like, give me the ball and get the fuck out of the way. I'm the most dominant player on the floor.
He goes and stretches way too much
further out and drifts out. Get your big ass on the block and fucking get the ball and go dominate. I think in a series, when a game slows down, which is why I also think that although they give up a lot of points, it's going to be good for them in this conference because of the fact that when the game slows down in the playoffs, they're not going to give up that many points because of the amount of talent that when the floor shrinks and the game shrinks in the playoffs, you know, you're going to have enough, like lengthy defenders out there. You got Jeff T, you got Jimmy Butler, you got Wiggins, and although Wiggins is a liability on defense, he's at least athletic enough to try to stay with most people.
If that makes sense.
But I think Jimmy Butler can win you a playoff series. I didn't see it last year, but I think he has that potential in him, and I think Cat does. So that's why I think, and like, if they can get a hot streak and somehow find a way to come together on the defensive end moving into the playoffs, they can be scary for any team to me, except the Warriors, because the Warriors always destroy them.
I think they can be scary for any team, but I don't know if this year is the year that they take that next step. The one thing that I do like about them is they have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, pretty much 7 guys potentially who I think can all go get you a bucket. Tyrese Jones, Jamal Crawford, Jeff Teague, Taj. You can still dump the ball to Taj to get you a bucket. Cat, Wiggins, and Butler. In a playoff series, most teams do not really have 7 guys who, when all hell breaks loose, can go get you a bucket. That's one thing that they have, which will make them a tough out for anybody. I don't think the Timberwolves will be an easy out for anybody, but I got to see Wiggins and Cat on the big stage first before I'm convinced in them. Mm-hmm. I just have to see them
on the big stage. I don't even care about Wiggins. Stage. Wiggins is an afterthought to me.
He's an afterthought, but he's still a guy that you need to play well in a playoff series. Because, again, let's say you do play against the Spurs, right, mm-hmm. and Kawhi's 100% healthy. That means Jimmy Butler is somewhat neutralized, right?
Yeah. But who can stop Karl Anthony Towns? No one.
Stop.
Powell can't. LaMarcus can't. So that means get your big ass on the block.
Yes, but with the way Pop is, I think Pop can game plan for Cat. So it's like,
How do you game plan for a 7-footer who can shoot, who can post up, who can play in the mid-range, who's got a great dribble, like who can stretch out damn near to 30 feet? How do you defend that? You can't. No one can defend him. That's why he keeps averaging 22 and 10.
Yeah, but
even as a rookie, he was averaging that shit because he's unstoppable.
Yes,
he's unstoppable.
Yes, theoretically, I don't think Cat is unstoppable yet. I think Cat is about 2 years away from actually being. I think Cat still needs to get stronger. I think he plays on the perimeter a lot because he's 244 pounds.
Yeah.
I think Cat still can put on about 10 pounds of muscle, which would help him out a whole lot.
I think 20 more so.
It might affect how fast he is.
He needs to develop in his
frame. I don't necessarily care about him being fast because if you look at a player like Embiid, he's a humongous human being.
But Cat not Embiid.
Yes, no, but I'm not saying you're trying to get him to be that big. But putting on 20 more pounds will allow him to be able to if you get in the projected into the future, you get to the finals or you get to that point, you can deal with guys like him and AD and Boogie if you Cat. He's too small, which is why he's not that good on defense, because people can kind of take advantage of him and they can push him around. So he needs to get that more, more upper body strength, and he needs to work on his defensive principles more. But I think that offensively, he to me is a guy in this playoffs where like it's a guy that like where you think like damn who's a player that can randomly go off for 30 in a series or 30 is Cat is the guy.